टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न क्लास 11th बायोलॉजी चैप्टर फर्स्ट द लिविंग वर्ड्स. सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन अराइजेस इन आवर माइंड दैट व्हाट इज लिविंग. सो लाइफ इज यूनिक कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स दैट एक्सप्रेस इटसेल्फ थ्रू ए केमिकल रिएक्शन विच लीड्स थ्रू ग्रोथ डेवलपमेंट रिस्पॉन्सिवनेस adaptation and reproduction. So the object which exhibit growth, development, responsiveness and other characteristic of life are designated as living being. So what are the characteristic of living being? The first characteristic is growth. Growth is irreversible. Increase in mass of an individual, a multicellular organism increase its mass by cell division. While in plants, this growth by cell division occurs continuously throughout their lifespan, while in animals, this growth is seen only up to a certain age. You must remember that increase in body mass is considered as growth. Okay, when there is increase in body mass, then that is considered as growth. In non-living objects like mountains, boulders and sand mountains also grow up by accumulation of material on the surface. So non-living objects, they are also show the growth. In living organism, growth in living organism occur from the inside. So living organism growth is occur from the inside, while non-living organism the growth is occur from the outside. So growth is occur in both living and non-living. That's why growth is not considered as a defining property. The next property is reproduction. So it is the formation of new individual of the similar kind of itself. Reproduction is not essential for the survival of the individual. Ability for reproduction develops when a young individual becomes mature. Reproduction is of two types. You already know that asexual and sexual. Asexual reproduction kya? What? They are uniparental. There is no formation of gametes occur. While in sexual reproduction, they are biparental and there is formation of gametes occur. If there is formation of gamete, then also there is fertilization is occur. While in asexual reproduction, there is no fertilization is occur. So let's learn. What is asexual reproduction? Asexual reproduction is the formation of new individuals from specialized or unspecialized parts of a single parent. Without the formation and fusion of gametes, it occurs by spore, binary fission, multiple fission, fragmentation and regeneration. You already learn asexual reproduction in class 10th, how do organism reproduce chapter. On the other hand, sexual reproduction involves the formation and fusion of two types of sex cells or gametes. The fusion product or zygote give rise to an offspring. In unicellular organism, growth and reproduction are synonyms. In unicellular organisms, growth and reproduction are synonyms means in unicellular organism, the growth means the cell is going to be divide. If the cell is going to, then there is two organisms are formed. Like if there is amoeba is present and in amoeba binary fission is occur, then two daughter amoebae are formed. So this is also known as growth and reproduction. Both are synonyms. Second point is many organisms do not reproduce, like mules, sterile worker bees, infertile human couples. Therefore, reproduction is not all inclusive characteristic of living organism, means it is also not the defining property of the living being. And the third is metabolism. All living organisms are made of chemicals. These chemicals, small and big, belonging to various classes, size, functions, etc., are constantly being made and changed into some other biomolecules. These conversions are chemical reaction or metabolic reaction. Metabolism is a defining property of living organism because it does not occur in the non-livings. All activities of an organism, including growth, movement, development, responsiveness, reproduction, etc., are due to metabolism. Metabolism is of two types. First is anabolism and second is catabolism. So what is anabolism? Anabolism includes all the building up reaction. It also called constructive metabolism. Anabolism involves the synthesis of complex substances from simpler ones. Example, you can take the example of synthesis of organic compounds from CO2 and H2O during photosynthesis. Means during photosynthesis there is preparation of food is occur. So CO2 and H2O in the presence of sunlight and chloroform they form glucose molecule. In anabolism there is formation of complex substances occur from the simpler ones. Oh, the next is catabolism. Catabolism constitute breakdown reaction. It is also known as destructive metabolism because it involves breaking of complex substances into simpler ones. Example, you can take the example of respiration. There is breakdown of food is occur to yield the energy. So in catabolism, there is a breakdown of food means glucose. So look the reaction. C6H12O6 plus 6O2 in the presence of enzyme it is break down into CO2 and H2O plus it yields energy. Thus anabolism is constructive and while catabolism means destructive, means there is synthesis occur in anabolism while catabolism there is destruction or breakdown is occur. So both constitute the metabolism. So the next property of living being is consciousness. So it is awareness of the surroundings and response to external stimuli. The external stimuli can be chemical or biological. The stimuli are perceived by sense organs in higher animals. Consciousness is said to be the defining property of the living being. So it is also the defining property of the living being. Some others properties of the living being are energy. Means all the living being are required energy to perform any function. Their body organization, the living being's organized body organization is different from the non-living. Homeostasis means every living organism maintain their internal environment, means body temperature. If there is a change in environment occur, they do not cause more impact on them. So healing and repair, you already know in a living being there is a, if there any type of wound is occur, then it's heal and repair itself. And disposal of waste dispose, and every living being have a fixed lifespan. So the time period from their birth to the death, natural death, is known as its lifespan. So they have a fixed time period, and death, every living being means in death case, means every living being there is a time come then their death is occur. So this is all about the characteristic of the living being. So the next topic is diversity in the living world. So biodiversity, we will read the different types of organisms and their classification based on their hierarchical classification system in the next section. As you already know, there are millions of living organisms such as plants, animal, bacteria and slime molds are present on the earth. Currently 1.7 to 1.8 million living organisms have been discovered so far. About 1.25 million species of animals and 0.55 million species of plants have been studied and provided names for identification. Single group of insects, however, outnumber all the plants. Every year, about 15,000 new organisms are discovered. Thousands are still unknown and are yet to be identified and described. It is practically impossible to study each and every individual. Also, it is difficult to remember their name, characters and uses. So the biologists have devised techniques for identification, naming and grouping of various organisms depending on the extent of their similarities and differences as per certain rules. So there is a term is given which is known as systematics. So the scientists who study and contribute the classification of organisms are known as systematics or taxonomists, and their subject is called systematics. in Latin, systema means order or sequence. Term systematicus was coined by Carl von Linnaeus. Generally, the term such as classification, systematics, and taxonomy are used interchangeably, but taxonomists like G. Simpson separate them to separate fields. So what is systematic? It is the study of diversity of organisms and their comparative and evolutionary relationship. Comparative and evolutionary relationship based on comparative and evolutionary relationships like anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, and ecology. The next is classification. According to Simpsons, classification is a subtopic of systematics that deals with ordering of organisms into group and taxonomy as a study of principles and procedure of classification. Next, species. John Ray, an English naturalist, coined the term species for a group of morphologically similar organisms and also tried to differentiate between genus and species. The term monocotyledons and dicotyledons were also coined by him. Carolus Linnaeus, a Swedish naturalist often referred to as father of taxonomy, published Systema Nature. ठीक है, सिस्टेमा नेचर एंड डिस्क्राइब 4326 स्पीसीज ऑफ एनिमल्स. द नेक्स्ट इज स्पीसीज प्लांटेरम 1753 कंटेन्ड डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ 5900 स्पीसीज ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड दीज वेयर अरेंज अकॉर्डिंग टू हिज सिस्टम ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन बेस्ड ऑन सेक्सुअल करेक्टर्स. लिनियस ऑल्सो इंट्रोड्यूस ए सिस्टम ऑफ नॉमिनक्लेचर of plants and animals, which is known as binomial nomenclature. So what are the rules of binomial nomenclature? So first rule is biological names are generally written in Latin and in italics. The first word in a biological name represents the genus, while the second component denotes the species. Specific epithet means species. So third rule is both the words in a biological name when handwritten are separately underlined or printed in italics to indicate their Latin version. Latin origin means if you write down in written, then you should underline both genus and species. And while if you there is printed form, then it is written in italic. Fourth rule, the first word denoting the genus is starting with capital letter, while the specific epithet start with a small letter. Example, like the what is the scientific name of mango? There is Mangifera indica. So both are separately underlined, Mangifera underlined and indica underlined separately. So next is topic is taxonomic categories or taxonomic hierarchy. It is also called lineal hierarchy because it was first proposed by Linnaeus. So hierarchy of categories is the classification of organisms in a definite sequence of categories, which is known as taxonomic categories, in a descending order starting from kingdom and reaching up to species. So first taxonomic hierarchy, there is first kingdom, second is phylum or division for plants, third is class, fourth is order, fifth is family, and then genus, and then species. So kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species. So the smallest unit of classification is species and the largest is kingdom. So what we are going to learn each one by one. So starting from the species. So what is species? Species is a natural population of individuals or group of population which resembles one another in all essential morphological and reproductive character, so that they are able to interbreed freely and produce fertile offspring. The next is genus. It is a group of related species which resembles one another in certain correlated characters. correlated characters are the those which similar or common features which are used in delimitation of a taxon above the rank of a species. Next is family. It is a taxonomic category which contains one or more related genera. All the genera of a family have some common features or correlated characters. They are separated from genera of a related family by important and characteristic differences in both vegetative and reproductive features. Next is order. The category includes one or more related family class. A class is made up of one or more related orders. So division or phylum, division for plants and phylum for animals. It is a category higher than that of class. The term phylum is used for animals while division is commonly employed for plants. A division or phylum is formed of one or more classes. Means division or phylum contain one or more classes. In the last, kingdom. It is the highest taxonomic categories. All plants are included in phylum Plantae, while all animals belong to kingdom Animalia. Okay, so in last there is a taxon. What are the taxonomical aids, tools for a study of taxonomy? So we are going to study the taxonomical aids. Taxonomical aids means what are the techniques, procedure and stored information that are useful in identification and classification of organisms are called taxonomical aids. The first is herbarium. So what is herbarium? Herbarium is a place where dried and pressed plant specimens mounted on seats are kept systematically according to a widely accepted system of classification. So what is the uses of herbarium? Herbarium collect information about the local flora as well as flora of distant areas. Second, correct and authentic information of unknown plants. Third, it is helpful in breeding programs for evolving newer and better varieties. So some important herbaria are named Royal Botanical Garden, Kew, situated in London. It is the largest herbarium which have 6.5 million number of species present. Second, Central National Herbarium, Indian Botanical Gardens, present in Kolkata. It have 2.0 million number of species. Third is NBRI, that is National Botanical Research Institute in Lucknow. It is situated in Lucknow, and in Lucknow there is 80,000 number of species are present. So how we recognize the identification of species? First, there is manual. It is a handy book containing instruction as to occurrence, collection and identification of species found in a particular area. Another is monograph. It is a treatise having all the information about a particular taxon like family or genus. Catalog. It is a list or register that enumerate methodically all the species found in a particular place, often with very brief description adding identification. Next is key. It is a booklet containing list of characters and their alternates which are helpful in identification of various taxa like class, order, genus and species. Next is botanical gardens. Botanical gardens are sufficiently large size tracts where plants of different types and areas are grown for scientific and educational purpose. The first real botanical garden developed by Theophrastus in 370-285 BC. Name Royal First. Some of the botanical gardens. First is Royal Botanical Garden, situated in Kew, London. It has an area of 300 acres but grows a very large number of plants. Second is Indian Botanical Garden, present in Kolkata. Third is National Botanical Garden, present in Lucknow. Next is museum. You already know that the word museum comes from the Greek word museion. Museum is an institution where artistic and educational material are exhibited to the public. The materials available for observation and study are called a collection. Next is Zoological Park. Instead of zoos, zoological parks or zoological gardens are established where high standard of care is observed and the animals live under more natural conditions. The next is key. Key for identification. Key is another taxonomical aid used for identification of plants and animals based on similarities and dissimilarities. The keys are based on the contrasting characters generally in a pair called couplet. It represents the choice made between two opposite options. Each statement in the key is called a lead. Separate taxonomical keys are used for each taxonomic category like family, genus, and species.